Okay, so we're starting with atmosphere. So till now we have discussed in last chapter.
Sir, which chapter?
Atmosphere. It is 95 chapter. 95 page number. On 95 page number, 11 chapter will start. So composition as well as structure will be discussing. A brief idea will have about the composition and the structure of the atmosphere. Okay. So earlier we have discussed a little bit about lithosphere. That was one of the realms. So there are four realms. Earth has been divided into four realms. That is four regions you can call or domain of study. Okay, domain of activity. So which were there?
First realm, which were lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere, and biosphere.
Okay, first we'll be discussing only three: lithosphere, hydrosphere.
Atmosphere.
So lithosphere, it is mainly the solid part. We have discussed a little bit about that one. Hydrosphere as well, we have discussed the liquid part. The oceans we have discussed. Okay, atmosphere we'll be discussing. It is the gaseous part. Now one more realm is there, that is biosphere. So see here, wherever these three spheres, that is these three realms interact, biosphere take place. Or biosphere is occurs where these three realms interact. Wherever the land, water, and gas, that is air interact, we have biosphere, that is life. Life forms are there. So where we have interaction of these three, biosphere will be there. Is this clear? So biosphere is the resultant of interaction of all these three realms. Is this clear? So biosphere mainly is discussed in ecology. In geography, we will be limited with lithosphere, hydrosphere, and atmosphere. Little bit biosphere may be possible there, but mainly we discuss it in ecology. Sorry. So we will be starting with structure. Okay, see here, lithosphere we have done the structure: crust, core, crust, mantle, and core. And then again further divided, we have studied the composition as well, but now we'll be studying atmosphere. So structure, so if this is the earth, we are having envelope of air surrounding us. Okay, air, we have the gases we have surrounding us, and this envelope is called as atmosphere. This envelope is called as atmosphere. Atmos mainly atmo means air. A sphere of air we are having surrounding us. A blanket of air surrounding us, that is called as atmosphere. So it is a gaseous part surrounding the earth, and we call it as atmosphere. So it is composed of different kinds of gases. Atmosphere is composed of different kinds of gases. So what gases can be? Nitrogen is there.
Oxygen, hydrogen.
Yes, many more, many gases are there, but mainly how much is it? It is 71%. How much oxygen?
21%.
21%. Okay, nitrogen is 78%, oxygen is 21%. Okay, so remaining is 1%. So main constituent of our atmosphere is nitrogen. That is, it accounts for 78% of the whole atmosphere. We have nitrogen. 21% is oxygen. Now remaining is what? 1%. The rest of the gases, they constitute just 1% of our atmosphere. And in that, 0.93% is argon. It is an inert gas. 0.93% is argon. Now, remaining is how much?
0.3% carbon dioxide.
Carbon dioxide is 0.033%. This is our CO2. Okay, so main constituent of our atmosphere is nitrogen. That is 78% of the whole atmosphere accounts nitrogen. Oxygen 21%. Remaining 1% gases are there. And in that 0.93% is argon. Remaining gases 0.07%. And among that CO2 is 0.003%. And this gas is very, very important gas because it has high potential to absorb heat. It can absorb heat. It has high potential to absorb it. So it is one of the greenhouse gases responsible for warming of the earth, global warming of the earth. So this will discuss when we discuss the global warming. Is this
clear? CO2 is, sir, yes, CO2 is
0.33%. 0.033%. Okay, see here, 78% we already has nitrogen, 21% we have oxygen, 1% is remaining. In that 0.93% is argon.
So that is 0.33%.
0.033%. This is argon. Now remaining is how much? 0.07%. And among them, 0.033% is CO2. 0.033. Is CO2. So even a slight bit difference in this percentage, the temperature of the earth changes. So it is one of the most effective greenhouse gas. We will discuss. Is this clear now? Okay. Now we discuss. See here. We'll be dividing the atmosphere into two parts based on gaseous. Gaseous structure. Okay, that is composition of the gas, how they are mixed. So see here, we have homosphere. It is up to 80 kilometer. So from the surface of the earth up to the height of 80 kilometer, we have homosphere. And above this, we have
heterosphere.
So what does these words denote? Homosphere and heterosphere. Sphere is clear. Homo. Homo means the same like mixed structure. They are mixed. All the gases are mixed with one another. So we have homogeneous mixture of gases here. We have majorly the homogeneous mixture of gas. That is all gases are mixed with one another. Okay. We have mixture of gases. That is most of a homogeneous mixture. But here we have heterogeneous mixture. That means one gas may be lying over the other. So we may be having the layers of gases here. We are having layers of gases here. Is this clear? So in homosphere, that is up to 80 kilometers. We have homogeneous mixture. But above 80 kilometers, the gases starts to get into layers according to their density. So here we have heterogeneous mixture. Is this clear? Rest, yes, more like very dinosphere, those we'll be discussing afterwards. Okay. Heterosphere, homosphere, we'll again discuss a little bit afterwards. Okay. Now, first, we are just seeing the structure. Now, one more that classification is. One classification was on the gaseous mixture, that is whether it is homogeneous or heterogeneous. There's one more classification based on temperature, that is thermal. So see here, if this is the surface of the earth, this is our surface of the earth. As you move up in the atmosphere, the temperature increases or decreases?
Sir, decreases.
Temperature decreases. As you see here. We move towards the mountains, the temperature decreases. So at the height increases, the temperature decreases. So here the temperature decreases as we are moving up. So up to the some high here, up to here, the temperature decreases. Okay. So this first layer we named as troposphere. This is the first layer around the Earth. The temperature, as the altitude increases, temperature decreases. This is clear. So first layer is the troposphere. Now see here, tropos means here turbulence is there. It is called mixing. Here the wind system is there. All the weather phenomena take place in troposphere. That is cloud formation, the rain, all everything takes place in troposphere. And its height is around how much? 14 kilometers. Or it may range from 8 kilometers to 18 kilometers. Some book it is written from 8 kilometers to 20 kilometers or 16 kilometers as well. It is written. So 8 kilometers to 16 kilometers as well. So roughly it is around 14 kilometers. Average height, that is mean height, is 14 kilometers. It may range from about 8 kilometers to 18 kilometers. So it height varies. Now see here, how is height varies? This is our Earth. Okay. Again. Okay, this is our Earth, for example. Now the atmosphere, it is flattened on the poles, bit bulged on the equator side. Similarly, our atmosphere. So consider as a troposphere, the first layer only. Here it is around 18 kilometers. On the equator, the troposphere extends up to 18 kilometers of altitude. Here at poles, it is just 8 kilometers. So it is thickened at the equator and thinned at the poles. This is clear. So height of the troposphere. Height of the troposphere decreases as you move towards the poles. So in troposphere, all the weather phenomena take place. So what kind of phenomena? How the rain is formed? So what all gases it contains? Oxygen, carbon dioxide, all those gases along with water vapor. Mainly water vapor is concentrated in troposphere. Most of the water vapor is concentrated in troposphere. So see here, what happens? The water vapor, it rises up. Water vapor rises up. Now as it rises up, it gets cooled, it expands. As the height increases, pressure decreases. So it expands. As it expands, temperature decreases. It starts to cool down. It starts to condense. Those water vapors, it starts to condense. And when it condenses, it forms drops. So how drops are formed? See here. Here we have dust particles as well. They as well rise up in the atmosphere. Now those dust particles, they access nucleus. So around these dust particles, water vapor condenses. That is, it is converted into liquid and drops are formed. As they become heavy, they fall on the earth in the form of rain or precipitation, we call. In the form of rain, it falls, or in the form of snow. Okay. So all the weather phenomena is taking place in troposphere. Is this clear? Now,
yes, one sir.
More. One more thing I ask.
Excuse me, sir. Yes. Sir, if there is a no solid surface in the atmosphere, so where this droplets condenses?
See here, there are solid surfaces always. Dust particles are always there.
That means they condenses on dust particles.
Yes. Small dust particles, they are such nucleus. Around them, the water droplets starts to condense. Okay. Now, one more thing. Temperature is decreasing as you move up in the troposphere. At what rate it is decreasing? What is the rate at which the temperature decreases? So it is 6.4 degrees Celsius per kilometer. So if we move by 1 kilometer, it will decrease by 6.4 degrees Celsius. Just give me 1 second. So temperature decreases by 6.4 degrees Celsius per kilometer. This is the rate. This is called as normal lapse rate. Or mean lapse rate as well, we can say. normal lapse rate or mean lapse rate. So temperature decreases by 6.4 degrees Celsius for every kilometer of ascent. As you move up, the temperature decreases by 6.4 degrees Celsius for every kilometer. This is clear. This is the rate of decrease of temperature. So here, the structure of Earth is defined on the basis of this temperature. First layer, the temperature decreases as you move up. Okay, just go through the troposphere once if any doubt. For the time being, leave ionosphere, homosphere, and the main major gases and the important life. Importance to life that we'll discuss afterwards. Atmosphere, troposphere, the region of mixing, all the weather phenomena, average height we have discussed, water vapor and all we have discussed, humidity we have discussed, the precipitation, the water vapor, pollution we have discussed, all the particles we have, next important. Normal lapse rate we have discussed. So any doubt in there, just go through the troposphere once, just for a few seconds, go through it. Then we start the second layer. Yes, no doubts. So we can start the second layer. That is stratosphere. Now see here. Here the mean temperature around the
Earth is 50
degrees. Yes.
Sir, I have a doubt.
Yes.
Sir, why the clouds are existing in troposphere?
Okay, mainly clouds are existing in troposphere, some are in stratosphere as well. Okay, this. Okay, just give you 1 minute after that we discuss. Okay, see here the temperature is around. Here the temperature around is minus 50 degrees Celsius. At the this one as the troposphere ends. Okay, why the clouds are mainly concentrated here? So one reason that may be the density. Okay. Okay, that I can give. I may give you next lecture. I have to search for that one.
Okay,
sir, I think that the troposphere gives a suitable temperature for converting into droplets.
That is okay. We can say temperature, but there's more reasons are there. See, clouds are in there. Mainly, they are concentrated in troposphere. But few clouds are there in stratosphere as well. As well, few clouds we can see in mesosphere as well. They go, but mainly they are concentrated in troposphere.
So because of gravitational forces, they are held closer.
Maybe, but I have to go through it once. First, I have to confirm the reasons so that I can tell in class properly. Okay.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, in troposphere B part, fourth line, it is given under normal condition, the height of troposphere is about 8 kilometers at the poles. Sir, yes. So if conditions will not be normal, then it will increase or decrease?
So, see here. It is not fixed, that is, troposphere height is not fixed always. It keeps on changing a little bit. So we cannot say exactly it is 8 kilometers, it is saying like that. In normal conditions, we are saying it is about 8 kilometers. There may be some different weather phenomena and it may change. So it keeps on changing by a little bit.
Sir, how it is measured?
Okay, how it is measured? Okay, see here. First, we discuss the status a little bit. You will get to know a little after some time. You will get to know. Okay, see here. Okay, one way is there. You take the okay. I don't know how it is measured exactly, but one way I can tell you that here it is the point where the temperature in the first layer you are seeing the temperature decreasing. Up to here, temperature decreases. Afterwards, again the temperature starts to increase. So mainly this classification is based on temperature. So we are measuring the temperature as what, how the temperature is changing. We are denoting the layers. Okay, we are separating the layers. So in first layer, the temperature decreases. Up to here, the temperature decreases. Now what happens? As we move up, the temperature again starts to rise. So we have got the point where the temperature again starts to rise. So we can say that's the pause of the troposphere. And that is called as tropopause. So here it is paused. This is the limit of troposphere. So by noting the temperature, we can tell that here the troposphere ends. Up to here the temperature decreases. It goes up to minus 50 degrees Celsius. Now as you move further up, temperature again starts to rise. So here what happens at the tropopause? There's inversion of temperature. Temperature inversion takes place. So first it was decreasing. Now it starts to rise. So inversion of temperature starts to take place. We call it as tropopause as the is the layer where the temperature inversion takes place. So where the point where the temperature inversion takes place, that will be the troposphere. The layer at the temperature inversion takes place, that will be the troposphere or tropopause, we can say. That is the troposphere or the end of the troposphere.
Sir.
Yes.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
It could be the reason that the airplanes are flying in stratosphere because there are too much clouds in troposphere.
Yes, troposphere as well. Yes, there are more disturbance, turbulence is there. In stratosphere, it is mostly silent. So no disturbance are there. So jet waves are there. Okay. There are disturbance, but not that. Okay, that jet. Okay, leave that. Jet streams and all. We can discuss those later. But mainly, there is no disturbance here. Troposphere, it is the turbulence. All the weather phenomena are taking place. So if we fly here, it will be difficult for the airplanes. Here, it's kind of, we can say it is a silent zone for the airplanes. They fly mainly in stratosphere.
Sir, pardon me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, in the diagram, it is given that helicopter is in the troposphere. Where is that? Aeroplane is in the stratosphere.
Yes, mainly helicopters will fly in troposphere.
Sir, but even helicopters face the disturbance of the clouds.
Yes, it faces. It can fly in troposphere, stratosphere as well as helicopter. But it flies, it is given in here, helicopter troposphere.
Sir, because it is suitable for only small heights, for larger heights we can take an aeroplane.
Okay, that I have to check with helicopters. I'll check that one once more. Helicopters. Any more doubts?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, in which layer birds are flying?
Mainly they are concentrated in troposphere. In troposphere. In troposphere.
Okay,
okay. Okay, so troposphere is clear. Now we move to stratosphere. Next layer is stratosphere. So up to 14 kilometers we have troposphere, then tropopause. It separates the two layers, that is troposphere and stratosphere. Its height is about 50 kilometers. Now see here. Here the temperature was decreasing as we are moving up. Now the temperature will increase. In this layer, the temperature starts to increase. And around 50 kilometers, it is 10 degrees Celsius. It is around 10 degrees Celsius. So temperature has increased from minus 50 to 10 degrees Celsius. Okay.
Sir, and again, the
yes.
Sir, what is the reason for increasing of temperature?
Okay.
Sir, sun's rays.
Sun, that's everything for that, but why not here?
So because other layers absorb much of the sun's rays.
No, see here. Here, I'll give you the reason afterwards. Because this atmosphere is heated from the surface of the earth. Here, the atmosphere is heated from the surface of the earth. There's a reason for this why temperature decreases as you move up. That we'll discuss. Okay, when we discuss the insulation, we'll discuss that. Okay, because here the atmosphere is heated. First here, sun rays comes, they are long wave radiation because sun being hot, it radiates long wave radiation. The atmosphere is not mainly heated by long wave radiation. The surface of the earth absorbs those heat radiations. Now, this earth will become as a emitting body. It will radiate the heat. So Earth being a cold body, it will emit shortwave radiations. And the atmosphere is heated from shortwave radiation. That is, Earth heats the atmosphere. So near the surface, we will have high temperature. As you move up, the temperature will decrease. Okay, here, yes,
and
here.
After stratosphere, the temperature decreases.
After stratosphere, yes. Again, that's why we are here. What's the reason? We'll be discussing now. Okay. So see here, rays of the sun are coming here. So here, because of the rays of the sun, this temperature increases. So more, it will be increasing. Now see here, why it is called stratosphere? Troposphere we discussed. It is turbulence, mixing of all. Therefore, it is troposphere. Stratosphere, why it is called stratosphere? You have studied the stratovolcano. Have you studied that one? Okay, see here, strato means layers. That is, here we are having layers of gases. Note, it doesn't mean that layer of oxygen, layer of that one. Layers means we have on the top, we have warmer layers. That is, warmer layer of gas. And below we have cooler layer of gas. As so it is clear, temperature increases. So here we have the warmer layer of gas. Below it, we have cooler layer of gases. Therefore, it is called as stratosphere. We are having layers of warmer gases. Then we have the, at the top, we have the warmer gases. At the bottom, we have the cooler layers of gases. Therefore, it is called as stratosphere. Here, these are arranged in layers according to the temperature. So warmer layer on top, at bottom we have cooler layers. That's why it is called as stratosphere. Okay, and temperature, it increases up to 10 degrees Celsius of ascent. Now there's one more layer, very important layer, gas here. Which gas? In the stratosphere, there's one more very important gas. If it is not there, you will have the gas, ozone layer. So ozone gas we have. So around 20 to 30 kilometers we have ozone gas or ozone layer, we can say. We have ozone layer and it protects us from
ultraviolet rays.
So see here, sun radiation is coming. So it contains gamma rays, X-rays, various kind of rays as well. So UV rays mainly is absorbed here. UV rays are absorbed here so that we are safe from the UV rays. Okay, now see how the ozone layer functions. Ozone layer, what will be there? Oxygen are there. Oxygen is there. So, on the molecule of oxygen, when UV rays falls, what will happen? This oxygen molecule will dissociate into oxygen atoms. So, one oxygen molecule dissociates into two oxygen atoms. This is clear. Now see here, either they will combine together to form again the oxygen molecule, or one oxygen atom can combine with oxygen molecule to give us ozone. Okay, so oxygen absorbs the UV rays, two oxygen atoms are formed, then these are very unstable. So it again reacts with oxygen to form the ozone layer. Now ozone is formed. Now what happens? Ozone is formed again.
Excuse me, sir.
Sir,
why does the oxygen molecule dissociate?
Because of UV rays. This rays dissociates the oxygen molecule. More in depth, I don't know that one. How to find that?
There is this stratosphere is called.
See here, mainly what happens, see here, okay, this is oxygen atom. So UV rays, UV rays dissociates into two atoms. Why dissociate that, I have to search for. Okay, or you can ask the chemistry teacher, or I'll search and tell you in next lecture that one. So because of UV rays, it dissociates into atoms, now ozone is formed. So either they combine together again, oxygen is formed, or they form with other oxygen molecule and form ozone. Now see again, on ozone. UV rays falls and it again dissociates into O and O2. And this how it continues. It keeps on continuing. So from oxygen molecules, ozone is formed. Yes?
So this is a constant process.
This is continuously going on. So here, the from oxygen atoms, ozone is forming. From ozone, again, the oxygen is forming. And this is continuously forming. It is continuously happening here.
Sir, any other gas don't combine with oxygen?
Okay, they are combining, that we'll be discussing. That is destruction of ozone layer. Okay, so that we discuss. Okay, we discuss it now only. Okay. Now see here, for example, chlorine, bromine, or nitrogen, they all as well react with oxygen atoms. So what happens here? If chlorine is there, from O2 it is dissociated, O and O is formed. Now chlorine reacts with it, ClO is formed. Okay? And this is not ozone. ClO is formed. This chlorine acts as catalyst. Yes?
Sir, as we move from the Earth's surface to the Earth's layer, then the temperature of the Earth's layer increases or decreases?
Earth layer, in troposphere it decreases.
Yes. Then.
Yes. In the stratosphere it increases. See, in troposphere it has decreased up to minus 50 degrees Celsius. See, here this division is based on temperature only.
Okay.
So, the first layer temperature decreases, second layer temperature increases, then again decreases, again increases. So according to temperature, we have divided these layers. The homosphere, heterosphere, that was based on gaseous structure. Any how the gases are arranged, whether homogeneously mixed or heterogeneously they are. Okay, that was two classification. One based on gaseous mixture. This is based on temperature. This is based on temperature. Okay. So increases, decreases, it's happening like this. So according to temperature, we are classified the, okay. So, okay, 1 minute, one at a time. See, chlorine is there. Now, this is formed. It doesn't act as a, you, now see here. Here, chlorine acts as a catalyst. Here, chlorine acts as a catalyst. Now, ClO is formed. Again, it dissociates Cl plus O. Again, if O is there, it is forming like this. Again, so instead of O, formation of ozone, what is happening? Oxygen is dissociated first. Now chlorine reacts with it. Has more, it acts as a catalyst, it reacts with it. And now oxygen is forming. Again, the chlorine is forming. It will again dissociate the oxygen. Again, this will continue. So what happens here? One chlorine atom, it can dissociate, it can destroy 1 lakh ozone atoms, ozone molecules. One chlorine atom can destroy this much ozone molecules. So chlorine acts as a catalyst there. So more the chlorine in the atmosphere, ozone layer will decrease.
So time
ozone layer will decrease. Okay, so we'll continue.
Excuse
next question.
Sir.
Yes.
So why does only one oxygen atom combine with an oxygen molecule to form the ozone? Because any other element can also react.
Yes, see, that will depend on which are more affinity or which is more reactive. Yes, you can live. It is more reactive with the oxygen. This is more reactive with the oxygen atom. Therefore, it forms ClO. Now, ClO again will react the oxygen atom. It forms again from chlorine and oxygen. So ozone is not formed. That means one chlorine atom can destroy around 1 lakh ozone atoms, ozone molecules. Sorry, man. Ozone
sir,
molecules.
Sir, other than chlorine, also many
yes.
Elements are present.
Bromine can, fluorine can, or nitrogen as well. N2O plus O that is formed.
Excuse me, sir.
Sir, they don't contribute to the ozone layer.
No, they are not contributing. They are destroying the ozone layer. They are destroying the ozone layer. Because ozone is not forming.
So that's why there is a hole over there.
Yes. Like, yes, there's a hole. Whenever it gets rarefied, it is decreasing thickness. We call it as ozone layer. So on Antarctica, Australia, on Indian as well. So mainly at the poles it is.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, how can this chlorine and oxygen can combine? Because they both have electronegative characters. Means they both are electronegative. Cl minus and O2 minus.
Cl minus and O minus. Okay.
O2 minus.
Then they will be positive. Minus minus is positive.
No. Okay.
Sir, we will discuss tomorrow.
Okay, I have to go through chemistry, all this. Usually plus and minus used to combine.
Yes, sir.
Okay, here it is said when chlorine acts as a catalyst with this. Okay, I will go through all the depth, then we'll discuss, okay? Tomorrow last period we have.
Sir, then in the next class, we will start this chapter again.
So we have already started. We have completed most of them. Little bit we discuss this one and then we'll move to next. Okay, next layer we'll move.
Okay, sir.
So today you have a lot of work to search the doubts.
It's fine. It's good. Okay, any more doubts you have, you can text me on WhatsApp. Okay? I'll go through them all. Okay then, thank you.